Muhammad Ali was considered as one of the best and most successful fighter back in his time. And even Yujiro had a ton of respect for him. But his son Muhammad Ali Jr. took things to next level after completing the imaginary technique known as Art of Ali that his dad couldn't complete in his life. After getting raised by a person like Muhammad Ali and praised by a person like Yujiro Hanma, Ali Jr. was supposed to compete and defeat top tier fighters like Paki Hanma and Jack Hanma. And when we saw his reflexes against Yujiro Hanma, they were pretty impressive. Later he even defeated Topo Orochi and Koki Shibukawa, which was a pretty big achievement. Overall, it was clear that he could give a really good fight to top tier fighters like Paki Hanma or Jack Hanma. At least that's what we thought. Then in his fight with Jack Hanma, he got defeated and destroyed miserably. Not only this, but later he also lost his fight to Shibukawa, Dopo Orochi and Baki. Now let's see what actually went wrong. I'm going to break down the reason in two parts. Lack of experience. Ali Jr. started fighting from early age. Later he proceeded to fight a lot of other people and even world-class champions, and he destroyed them. But he never had the real fight experience, a fight where death is normal, a fight where anything goes, a fight with no rules, an unfair fight. Also, world-class champions are practically nothing in front of real fighters who fight in underground arenas. And his fight was against people who were literally dominating those underground arenas. Number 2. Lack of dedication and love. With one of the best genetics and a father like Muhammad Ali, Ali Jr. became really strong. And after completing Art of Ali, he was unstoppable. Even the world-class champions were nothing in front of him, which basically just led him to not train harder. Because how is he supposed to be dedicated if he easily defeats anyone coming in front of him? Or if he never had a real fight where fighters were on his level? We can see this lack of dedication when instead of getting angry and practicing more, he was taking bed rest after getting destroyed by Dopo and Shibukawa. He do not have a mentality of a real fighter who can give up anything, even his own life to win. He doesn't really have a motive to win. Also, he was madly in love with Kozue, and the way he used to talk to Kozue or the way he was crying after losing to Baki just shows that he needs love and fighting is just second priority. When asked by Kozue that if he is a fighter or not, he simply denies it. And if it is true, then it simply means that he never wanted to be a fighter who can do anything or lose anything to achieve victory. Even Baki says that Ali Jr. was never prepared to lose his life. When Ali Jr. fought Baki, he was powerful and experienced than before. But he was not ready to fight at all, because before the fight he was just thinking of how strong Baki was. The thoughts of the fact that Baki was stronger than Shibukawa, Dopo and Jack Hanma decreased his confidence. Also, during the fight, he wasn't focusing on the fight that much because he was full of different types of emotions and he was just puzzled. And all of this mess further led to decrease his chance of winning. Overall, Muhammad Ali Jr. is very powerful, but his mental strength is nowhere near Paki Hanma or Jack Hanma, which further limited his physical capabilities or his physical powers because he never had that required dedication or willpower to win. Let me know guys what you think of these reasons. Also tell me what you think of Muhammad Ali Jr. Thank you for watching guys. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and turn on the notifications bell. Also don't forget to like the video.